I'm like, get all this steady. What's up, you guys? It's like 5 a.m. and it's like 6 a.m. now, and we're actually pigging out at the Sands.
We just had laksa.
We did.
It's Who has laksa good. At 6 a.m.?
We
us.
Do.
Yeah, it's, exactly. Sonia said it's like after partying. Yeah. After partying, you have like, you know,
cravings, right?
Yeah, like I've never had laksa for supper, to be fair.
Yeah, I know.
That's quite heavy.
This was a good experience. And you know what? Look around us, Kaitan, so that we can show off the lounge, you know, like, what's up? We're gonna be here like VIP style.
Okay, well, yeah, we're just irritating everyone
this way.
So after that, she had porridge. I had miso because we read it like that.
Yes. Woo! Okay, we'll check back in on you also because my arms are tired. Bye!
Bye.
So gorgeous,
and the weather is even more gorgeous.
Exactly, but not as gorgeous as us,
right? Okay, she said it. Yes, of course, of course. There is much modesty in that statement.
Exactly, always. Let's get checked in, man.
Yay!
Let's go. What's up, you guys? We made a pit stop at this beautiful location.
At this rate, we're never going to get to the hotel, but who cares?
We're never. We're not even halfway through anything.
Bhutan, and today we've decided to dress up like Bhutanese princesses.
Yes, we can finally be queen of something.
I said princess, but she thinks
Sorry,
she's the queen.
Yeah, it's just for a day, lah. Come on. One day only, then I have to go back to Singapore, okay. You know?
And we have all these beautiful colours. Everyone has a different colour combi.
We do, and you know what? It just strikes me as something that I would not actually do in Singapore.
I'm not sure I would have put these two together,
yeah. And blue and orange, like, who would have thought?
But it looks good.
Yeah, thanks.
And now we're headed to, well, not quite sure where, but we'll see you there.
Yeah, we will.
Bye.
So we found ourselves at the Royal Textile Museum, and we're actually looking at, you know, how they created these beautiful
Kira.
Works of art. Yeah, so it's very complicated. Some of it even takes like 2 years to get done.
I think probably, like they said, mine probably takes two years.
About 2 years, right?
I mean, are wearing pieces of art.
Yeah, we are. Okay. Are we allowed to take this home?
We could try.
Okay,
we'll just go home.
It's a secret. Bye.
So we stopped for lunch. Still wearing the jacket because it's very cold in here.
Oh, and yes!
Everyone else is
I'm busy taking pictures.
Yeah, I know, right? But can we just eat now? Eat, yes. eat.
Let's go.
Narcissistically very satisfying about putting your face on a stamp, and I chose the shot of me attempting to do this archery thing at Tiger's Nest. Don't you love it? Now everyone wants a stamp from me, even if you don't, just pretend you do.
Hey there, we're at the Dolchula Pass. It is so beautiful, but my teeth are chattering. I'm quite sure it's minus. Let's go look for Sonia. Maybe she is frozen.
No, I need a hug.
It
is freezing.
My teeth are chattering.
But if you see the view here, it is totally worth it. I'm not talking about this view, like our faces, but the view behind
of the Himalayas. It is.
My teeth are chattering.
Yes, I actually feel.
I think the camera's shaking because Jade's head is shaking.
I'm so sorry about that, guys. Okay. We're gonna take some pictures and we'll catch you in a bit.
Bye!
All right. right now we're crossing the bridge. We're heading to our raft.
Yes, we are. Are you sure it's called a raft? I'm not really sure what it is.
It's white water rafting.
Oh yeah, that's true. That is true.
Are you guys excited in this cold weather though?
Yeah.
Okay, so is this the first time that you're white water rafting though?
No,
right? No. Okay, but it is the first time that it's going to be like icy, freezing cold.
Well, it's the first time anyone, I think, rafts in winter.
Yeah,
so.
I know. But you know what? The water is so clear right now.
It is so beautiful.
Very excited. Are there any like fish in Bhutan? I don't know.
Actually, I don't know.
Certain places, they are like wildlife, you know?
Well, I'm not sure they survive in this. Why don't I push you overboard and you can
find out?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. I'm a very good swimmer, actually. So we'll find... Oh! Wow, this bridge is actually, it gets a bit shaky.
Yeah. Okay, so we're going to say bye now and go get geared up.
Yes.
See ya in a bit.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Hey there, day 4 Bhutan, and today we've driven down to, yesterday, we are now in Panuka, which is a different region, and we're on the Kamsu Yule track. I keep looking down because I'm trying not to fall. And we're gonna trek for about an hour up to the top. I don't know if you can see it, there's a stupa right on the top. So, catch you in a bit. At the peak of the Kamsu Yule mountain hill, and this is the Kamsu Yule temple. Look at that, it's so beautiful. It was such a nice hike, about I think 30 minutes, and a pretty okay terrain, so I think most of you can do it as well. Just go slowly and take breaks if you need to. You can check out the view. Let's see. Just reached Paro. It's been a 3.5 hour drive, and we are ready for lunch in this very cute restaurant. These guys didn't even wait for me.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I hope you don't mind that we start without you.
If I mind it, not like I can do anything about it, right? But I think this place is so cute. Look at their balloons on the wall. I feel like we're in like a Bhutanese birthday party. Oh my god, guys, we just met our first cow and
it was very interesting.
It felt damn weird when you...
I know, it was soft and cushy.
Squishy.
And
then you pull it. It sounds so wrong.
Yeah, but
bad.
We had to milk the cow together. Does that mean we're best friends?
So we are very lucky today because we are going into a traditional Bhutanese house and kitchen, and we're gonna learn how to cook. So first you turn the car wheel. Then here is the kitchen. Hi. Guys, we are going on a helicopter ride.
Yes, we're gonna be so fly today. The two girls are going with us.
You guys excited?
Never.
You've been on a helicopter before.
No, never.
First time. We're gonna see Bhutan in a way we haven't seen before.
Absolutely.
Let's go! Right, so we just got off our first helicopter experience.
Yes.
How was it, guys?
Very good.
The question is, do you feel fly right now because we just took a
video? Okay, bye. On this trip, I learned that in Bhutanese culture, one is expected to think about death 5 times a day. So it's pretty morbid, but I think it's this sort of thinking about the end that keeps them feeling happy. And to be honest, on this trip there was such a sense of peace and a simple happiness in Bhutan in all the people that we met. It made me think that we're just kind of doing it all wrong in Singapore. Well, I know I'll be back and probably be back to climb more of Bhutan's many mountains.